Welcome to Go Fish with Dan Kenny. Today I'm with Captain Mel True, Block Island, striper fishing. Captain Mel here, what do you think? A little bit of maybe striped bass, maybe some sea bass. I don't know, what else are we gonna do?
Well, I tell you what, we've been out here for 5 minutes and our camera boat's already hooked up with a nice bass. So
there we go.
I don't think it will be long before we're hooked up. So sea bass, striped bass, bluefish, fluke, it's all here at Block Island. Come on out and get some. So Dan, while we're out here drifting around, it's not random drifting. We're actually looking for different waypoints throughout the column here. And right now we're coming on to a little bit of a rock pile, and you'll see where the water will change. It'll go from smooth to more of a dimply, where the tide's going over. And that's where we're gonna find the fish. Those fish are gonna be setting up on the structure, looking for bait fish to ambush as they come over. So hopefully we gotta give them some bait fish and a little bit of eel action. And we'll get these rods to go off and we'll be fighting the fish soon.
There we go.
First rod down. We're off the fish.
How many feet down, Mel?
We're in 40 feet right now. We got a fish at 30. These bass are gonna be sitting tight to the bottom. That's big bass.
All right. It is big. That's a good one. Let's go, baby. Knock yourself out. Look at that, Mel.
It's a big fish you got there, Dan.
Yep.
So you're fighting that on a lethal conventional reel. We got one of my 7 foot 30-50 rods on there.
Yeah, he's taking drag.
Yeah, that's a big fish. I'm gonna clear this line.
There we go, see him?
Yeah, come over the motor.
Yep. He's taking it again.
Yep, go ahead.
There we go.
Go ahead, go to the other side.
Yeah. Oh, he went on the other side now. Captain Mel, how about this, huh? Been on the water for a few minutes. Look at that fish.
That's a nice bass right there.
There it
so
is.
Dan, what we'll do is to get you to slide up here to your right.
Yeah. There he comes.
There you go. You can put your butt right on that metal bar there.
See him?
Rod this way. So you got yourself like a 25-pound bass there.
That's it. Coming back. You got the honest, brother? Look at that. Captain Mel True.
Here we go, buddy. How's that?
That was a
That's a beauty.
Fight.
It's a nice fish right there, my friend. Congratulations.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is what it's all about with Captain Mel, striper fishing, Rhode Island. Good job, buddy.
That's a beard. That's a nice one.
It was a lot of fun bringing them in, that's for sure.
Hey, these fish don't come in easy. You got to battle these fish. You know, it's not It's not like catching a schoolie.
No way.
That fish took you around the motor a couple times.
Yeah.
I can tell you, you're getting tired holding this puppy up.
It's a fight. All right.
Cool.
Let's put that back.
Good job.
So here we are, we're gonna sea bass on one of our live eels today. Great eating fish here in New England. If you haven't tried a sea bass before, it's probably one of the best eating fish. Highly recommend it that you keep a couple for the table.
All right, here, GoFishDan. Block Island is behind me, over there, over my right shoulder. We got the hills of Connecticut, and then over yonder, we got the state of New York. So it's pretty cool, just to let you know where we're fishing, with Captain Mel True, Fishnet Charters. It's gonna be a great day in the water.
Fish on?
Fish on. Yep.
Another sea bass.
Another sea bass. Fish on. I'll bring them up around the Yami.
Not our intended species, but it's a great fish.
Yeah.
Nonetheless.
There it comes. Get that line out of the way. There we go.
Woo, that's a big bluehead.
Yep.
Just swing that puppy right in. Yep. Nice. Good catch. Good catch.
There he goes.
Beautiful.
First
hit was a bluefish.
Yeah. Nice sea bass right here. And you had these for dinner last night.
Yeah, we grilled them up. A little butter, a little seasoning. It was great. Yeah, my new favorite fish for sure.
That's good.
Yeah. So he's going to come home with us.
Yep, there we go. Fillet that up with a nice Dexter blade.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
The edge.
The edge. Fish on, fish on, fish on. You got a real one there, Dan?
Yep.
All right. Try to go over to the left there.
Yep, I'm going to clear the line. Hold on.
Yep, perfect.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. And he's taking it, too. See if I can gain on him out. Whoa, boy. He did his little run here.
Yeah, they're going to do that run. There's not much you can do about that.
Nope.
Part of the fun.
Come on, baby. Come on. Stay buttoned up for me. There he comes. See him? What do you think about that one, Mel?
This is my office. It's hot, it's loud, and you don't even want to know what I spend on gas. So when I get home, I want it to be comfortable without spending a fortune on fuel. That's why I chose a water furnace geothermal heat pump. Water furnace units use the free renewable energy stored in your backyard to save up to 70% on heating, cooling, and hot water. It's like taking two cars off the road.
Two cars have suddenly vanished, handing Gordon the win here at Talon.
What do you mean I can't pick which two?
Wow, this is a good one. See him? Oh, keep him out of the line. What do you think about that one, Mel?
That's a beauty. You want to whip him?
Yep. I certainly going. Woo! Hold on a second, big boy.
There you go. It's your 35 pounder right,
right
there.
Beautiful. Woo! Look at that striper right there. Go Fish Dan, Block Island with Captain Mel True. It's a beauty right here. What a fight.
That's a fatty.
Woo! Look at that one.
So how we did this is we did a little three-way nice action on a live eel.
That's it.
We're running 40-pound gamma fluorocarbon, about 6 foot leader from the braid. Then we're running this little swivel with a dropper loop, 6 to 8 foot leader of fluorocarbon, 40-pound gamma to the hook. Number 5 live bait hook. Stuck that fish perfectly. Dan did a great job getting that puppy in.
You can stop now. This thing's heavy and all.
Yeah? All right. Well, we're going to get a big one next.
It's okay. Bring it in. It's another fish. Hey, Captain Mel, first of all, thank you for the invite to come out on your boat. And you got to let the viewers know a little bit about Mel True.
So 4 years ago, I decided to leave the corporate world, FCVS Pharmacy, to go out and start my own venture. I've been a fisherman my whole life, commercial fisherman, rod and reel fisherman, recreational fisherman. And I decided to take it to the next level, went out and got my captain's license. And for the last 4 years, I've been doing this full time. And tell you what, you never work a day in your life if you're doing something you love. And
yeah.
I tell you what, I put in some serious hours out here, and we do very well, and I enjoy every minute of it. And part of my business, how I structured my charter business, is I stay mobile. So
right. One
day I might be in P-Town, next day we're here at Block Island, next day might be Buzzards Bay. So I follow the fish. So I cater to my clients,
right. Depending
on what they want to catch, where they want to fish. And if you're willing to follow me, I'm willing to keep you on the fish. So it's working out very well for me, and I think it's a great way to go. Not too many guys are doing it.
No, it's obviously a great business model, trailing the boat and staying with the fish. Yep. Look up Captain Mel True, Fishnet Charters. Well, we fished this spot hard for a couple hours and Captain Mel says, let's move on out. So we're going to the next spot. That's a pretty nice boat.
These guys are all sea bass fishing. This whole fleet.
Follow the fish, keep moving around, doesn't hurt. We get all day, right?
You get all day. Where else would you rather be?
Nowhere
else.
It's
beautiful out here. We're gonna try some little top water action here with this new Uzi chum plug. This thing is phenomenal. You can jack this thing up with juice.
Yes.
Gum, chum, and Spencer's out the side. You're gonna see some fish all over this in about 3 minutes, I can guarantee you that. All right, here we come. We're coming up on the fish. Let's do this. I'm gonna spin the boat around, get us set up for the drift.
That Uzi jig's a great lure. I've seen him at my expo with that, and he puts the juice right in the head. It's a great concept, great idea.
He's got the Uzi jig, and now he's got the chum plug.
Yep. There we go.
So, action was a little slow, so I grabbed out a little soft plastic. Probably grabbed the sea bass here.
Yep. Flip it right in.
Nice female. Did a job on my lure here. I like to keep the males. Let the females go.
Splash. Since you started this 4 or 5 years ago, you know, one of the things that I've admired is that, oh, fish on. Oh yeah.
There you go, buddy.
I'll tell you what I was admiring about Mel True is your entrepreneurial spirit though. You got the wicked coolers, the custom rods here. And I just think that anybody that doesn't know you, that's pretty cool because you just, yeah, you got the guts to do this. Not only to quit your real job and do this on your own, but to set it all up and get your rods. Look at that.
Big old sea bass. Swing that baby in
here. Here we go.
1, 2, 3.
In. You gonna grab it?
That's
teamwork right there. You want me to lip it?
We got the other line as well. There we go.
Hey, we'll take it, man. That's...
It's a nice meal.
That's good on the dinner plate.
It'll be on the grill.
That's it. Nice. Sea bass on the grill. Yep. Just felt them. Oh, here he goes.
It's a bass. You're on, brother.
Oh, yeah.
Just hold tight.
Yeah, I got him. Yeah. I told you, I felt my eel being chased around. Oh, there he goes. Oh, I love it, Captain Mel. I love it. Yeah, and I had the rod in my hand, which is even better.
Which never happens.
That's always the best. Look at this thing. Look at this thing. Look at this thing.
Now, if you feel a rock on that, you need to let me know. I'm going to back up the boat. So, yeah, you know what? We're backing up.
Yep, back up the boat. Back up the boat. Back it up, man. Back it up. He took a couple of good runs, too. He wants to take. He's going back down there though. He wants to run again. Look at this. Look at this. A shark.
This is my office. It's hot, it's loud, and you don't even want to know what I spend on gas. So when I get home, I want it to be comfortable without spending a fortune on fuel. That's why I chose a water furnace geothermal heat pump. Water furnace units use the free renewable energy stored in your backyard to save up to 70% on heating, cooling, and hot water. It's like taking two cars off the road.
Two cars have suddenly vanished, handing Gordon the win here at
What do you mean I can't pick which two?
Oh man, what a fight. Yeah, but he's gone down. He went down there three times now, Mel. Let me get him over here. Look at that, under the motor. Oh my goodness. Well, this is a little bit of excitement for today. Here he comes. Can finally see him.
Oh,
look at this. Look at this.
Are you kidding me?
A shark.
Dude, that's a 50 pounder.
I love doing that.
Come over here, brother.
I know.
This one's coming home.
Yeah, baby. Now you know why he took a bunch of runs on me. Woo! How many runs did he take on me, Mel? Hey! I kept fighting him, man. Go Fish Dan, Mel True.
Ooh, that's what we're all about right there, man.
Three runs, down in the rocks, back trolling the motor. Thanks for your help, man.
Yes, sir, look at this.
For a moment there, I was like, don't go down in the rocks. Yeah, he's in the rocks. We went back and got him though, didn't we?
Dude, look it, right in the lip.
Oh, perfect.
Right in the tip of the lip.
I planned that hook set. I dreamed about it all last night.
Dude.
Look at that.
That's high 40s right there.
Yeah.
High 40s.
Beautiful fish.
Oh, baby.
Yes. I Dude. Love it.
12 o'clock in the afternoon, right?
That's it.
We're on the road at 2 o'clock this morning.
That's it.
Fish got out here super early. 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Amazing.
That's all worth it right there.
That's.
Oh, my pumped. The heart's still going. because like I said, I mean, I can tell this story forever. He went down, he ran, and we both know, we catch a lot of stripers, right? Yep. Yep. They usually take that one run that they're famous for.
Yep.
This guy legit, three times went down, came back up. Went down, came back up. Oh man, what a nice fish.
Hold that puppy up.
Oh yeah. GoFish Dan with a 46 pounder.
Yeah, it's all 40 plus, that's for sure.
45?
Yeah, I'd love to get a scale on that puppy.
Me too. Here we go. For some reason, the left side of the boat was like popping today. Look at that. It's got a little bit more choppy out here now. Yeah, it did. Now, Mel, how come the left side rod popped all day? Look at this. Look at this. Dude, I am totally lucky today. Fishing. Look at that. Yep. Yeah, I'm going to get him.
We'll get you to lip him.
You got it. Look at this, baby. Another one to the boat. Yeah. Yeah, it is. I had to sit down. Look at this.
Whew. Dan's getting it done. I lost mine. I had on. Pulled the hook at the boat.
Look at this.
Again, Captain Mel True series rod.
That's it.
Santiago.
Now, seriously, people are going to see the show, and this is legit. We, Mel and I had an agreement. I mean, obviously, he's the captain. We went out, right side rod, left side. We've pretty much been doing it all day. This side just kept popping. So, thank you. I'll take it.
That's a good fish right there, my friend.
Yeah, it is. Look at this. Still got the eel in his mouth. Look at that. See that?
Grab his belly.
Not a bad day. What a great day of striper fishing with Mel True.
You want to get out here? Fishnet Charters.
That's it.
CaptainMelTrue.com.
And show the viewers that eel. He still got it in his mouth. Look at that. GoFish Dan, Mel True with an epic day for stripers. He's a hungry fish.
Yes, sir.
50 pounder, right there on Captain Mel's boat. I'm so thankful that you named that spot after me. It's an honor to catch those fish on your boat. Well, Captain Mel, what can I say? I had the lucky rod today on this side of the boat, and you know,
yep,
but
sure did.
You did a great job backing down the boat, putting the boat in position that we talked about a couple times today.
It was a team effort today. We need someone to man that rod and keep it tight, and we had to back down on a couple of these fish, and some of them got away, but some didn't.
That's it. Well, let's go put this on the Dexter Edge, and it'll be on my grill tonight.
Beautiful.
Can't wait.
Same here, my friend. All right, let's do it.
As you know, we're Dexter Outdoors, you're on the team, and we got the powder coating, which came out at ICAST last year. Tiger Edge SG-142, it's a beast. The 8-inch fillet knife, and Let's rip off the striper. What do you say?
Let's do it. So these are my tools of the trade here. We get these out every day. You make our customers happy. We get in there with the tiger edge first, make our initial cut. This fish has been iced down for about half a day, you know, so we should have some nice firm meat. We'll just follow on the spine.
Tell you, this tiger edge, and I know you use it every day, you know that, but I mean, the reviews that Dexter has received on that one knife, coated or not, because it's obviously been out for a long time, that uncoated blade.
Correct.
But everyone who's anybody in the industry just raves about that knife. It doesn't get any better as far as having to rip through things, cartilage, bone, chunking, whatever your use is. It's just, I mean, it doesn't get any better than that Tiger Edge blade.
That one knife you can do everything with. There's no doubt about that.
Think about that blade. 400 fish, still cutting through them. Right?
We did a lot of sea bass with these the other day.
Sick.
I know. It is a beast. We're drifting here in Point Judith Harbor. So just keeping an eye on things.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Wind picked up.
Yeah, sure did.
Usually you get that tide change. We had a nice west wind all morning. And as soon as that tide changed, the wind changed, the fishing got really good.
And we had to leave.
And it was time.
The wind picked up, the fishing got better. Now your family's gonna get some of this as well.
Oh yeah.
I don't know about tonight, but.
We had some great sea bass last night. There we go. Pop the belly so she sinks.
And she goes, bang.
Ba-doom. Make myself a little slit for a finger hold. Makes life a lot easier for everybody.
Hey, no seagulls knows what's coming. They saw you there, they're like, okay, here comes another seal. Now, the thing is, some of these guys, I mean, we all like to eat, but that seagull right there is just greedy. He just had a 6-inch strip and he came back for another one.
So here we are, we got the bloodline here. We'll take a chunk of it out.
He's waiting for the bloodline. He didn't go after the skin.
Yeah, he's not complaining it tastes fishy.
Look at this, he's waiting for that. These guys know the deal, look at that. They're ready to fight each other too for it. Yeah.
There you go. Beautiful piece of meat.
Boy, is that good. Striped bass is delish.
Striped bass in the ocean.
Rocking and rolling. Yep. You gonna do that other one? Not the big one.